topic is microwave measurements. This is a topic in the subject microwave engineering. This is a topic in microwave engineering. Let me introduce myself. I am T. Gayatri, an associate professor in Department of EC at KG Reddy College of Engineering and Technology. So we have a subject microwave engineering in final year ECE, and this is a topic of that subject, microwave engineering. So basically, for microwave measurements, we have to know about the microwave bench setup. A microwave bench setup consists of a signal generator. The first block of the microwave bench setup is a signal generator. The second block of microwave signal generator, microwave bench setup, is an isolator. Then we have a variable attenuator. After the variable attenuator, we have a block called flap attenuator, which provides further attenuation. After both the attenuators, we have a frequency meter. For the measurement of frequency. Then we have a slotted line section. After the slotted line section, we have a detector mount. It is just like a demodulator. Further, the detector mount is connected to a VSWR meter or a CRO. Now, coming to the first block, microwave signal generator, it provides a continuous wave signal. It is modulated with a square wave signal, square wave modulated of 1 kHz frequency. This signal is taken as a microwave signal generator. The microwave signal generator consists of a klystron oscillator or a gun oscillator. Later, this signal is provided to the isolator. What the isolator does, isolator will transfer the signal from one end to another end. That is, it will transfer the signal from microwave signal generator to the detector mount. Whenever we get some reflected waves, some standing waves are formed. Such reflected wave is stopped at this isolator, such that the reflected wave will not touch the signal generator, as the signal generator is a costly equipment and it will be damaged by the reflected wave. So we use an isolator here. It will send only one direction propagation. Any reverse wave which is coming, it is attenuated at the isolator. This block will attenuate that signal. Then we have a variable attenuator and flap attenuator. Two attenuators are there, variable attenuator and a flap attenuator. We know that microwave signals are powerful signals. Such powerful signals may damage the load or any other meters which are connected. So we need to attenuate that powerful signal. So we have a variable attenuator, and if we want further attenuation, it is provided by a flap attenuator. So after the attenuators, we have a frequency meter. It can be analog frequency meter or a digital frequency meter, but we have a frequency meter. It is used for the measurement of the frequency of the signal. Then this frequency, after the frequency meter, we have a slotted line, which is very important block of microwave bench setup. This slotted line plays a key role in majority of the measurement experiments, all the measurement experiments. So after the slotted line, it has various functionalities. It will measure various things. It plays an important role in measurement of attenuation, VSWR and impedance. So then we have a detector mount. It is just like a demodulator. Now here I have sent a square wave modulated wave and that should be demodulated. So here we have a detector mount. Detector is nothing but a demodulator. Later the detector mount can be further connected to a VSWR meter or a reflector meter or a CRO for the further continuation of the measurements. Now what measurements we have in our subject? We have power measurements. We have attenuation measurements. We have VSWR measurements. We have impedance measurements in our subject. So these are the measurements available in microwave engineering. Power measurement, attenuation measurement, VSWR measurement and impedance measurement. Coming to the first topic, power measurement. So power. Power have different techniques. We have very low power, medium power and high power. So this power is categorized into three. Very low power, medium power, high power. The very low power which has a power of less than 1 milliwatt. But less than 1 milliwatt signal is known as very low power signal, and that can be measured using two techniques called as Schottky diode technique or thermocouple sensor. So we have two techniques for measuring very low power signal, Schottky diode technique and a thermocouple sensor. And for the medium power, which has a power less than 10 milliwatt, we use bolometer. So bolometer is a microwave device used for measuring medium power, that is less than 10 milliwatts. And if you have a high power signal greater than 10 milliwatt, we use a technique called calorimeter. So this is a technique, high power measurement technique. So these are the power measurements in the microwave measurements. The first one, power. Then the next one is attenuation. There is only one method for measuring the attenuation in our syllabus. So that attenuation measurement, you have a bend setter and you have to write how the attenuation is measured using the microwave bend setter. And the next topic is VSWR. For VSWR, we have two techniques. So the first technique is slotted line set technique, that is using the slotted line we can measure the VSWR. So the first technique of the VSWR measurement in our subject is slotted line technique, and the second technique is double minima method. The last technique is nothing but impedance measurement, which is there in our syllabus. Impedance measurement. So again, impedance measurement is of two categories, slotted line technique and reflectometer technique. So these are the two techniques for the impedance measurement, slotted line technique and reflectometer. Thank you.